बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर निगत असलम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोकेमिस्ट्री। दिस इज़ माई सेकेंड लेक्चर रिगार्डिंग प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस एंड द जेनेटिक कोड। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट वॉट आर द कम्पोनेंट्स विच आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस। सो द फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द कम्पोनेंट्स विच आर रिक्वायर्ड इज द अमीनो एसिड्स। ऑल द अमीनो एसिड्स that are present in the final proteins, they must be present during the protein synthesis. If one of the amino acid is missing, then the protein synthesis will stop. The second is the transfer RNA. Second requirement for the protein synthesis is the transfer RNA. At least 50 transfer RNA they are present in the humans for 20 amino acids, and 30 to 40 transfer RNAs they are present in the bacteria. Anticodons, what are anticodons? They are the three base nucleotide sequence on the transfer RNA. Some amino acids they have more than one specific transfer RNA, so that's why there are more than 20 transfer RNAs, that is 50 transfer RNA for 20 amino acids. So when amino acid is attached, this attachment is covalent. When amino acid is attached to the transfer RNA, that transfer RNA is called the charged transfer RNA. And how it is linked? This is linked by the covalent linkage, and covalent linkage alpha amino carboxyl group of the amino acid and 3' hydroxyl group of the ribose, they form the ester linkage, and they are attached with the CCA 3' end of the transfer RNA, which has the CCA. The amino acid is present at the CCA. And if the amino acid is not bound, the transfer RNA is called the uncharged transfer RNA. The amino acid attached with transfer RNA is said to be activated. So the amino acid is activated if it is attached with transfer RNA. This is the picture of transfer RNA which is attached with the messenger RNA. At the 3' end there is the methionine, and it is linked with the mRNA. mRNA has the codon, and the transfer RNA it has the anticodon. mRNA has the AUG, which is written in the 5' to 3' end, and the anti-parallel, there is the anti-parallel linkage of the or bonding of the anticodon with the codons. And next component which is required for the protein synthesis, they are the enzymes. The first the family of almost 20 different enzyme is required for the attachment of amino acid to the transfer RNA. Amino acyl transfer RNA synthetase. This is the amino acyl transfer RNA synthetase which attaches the amino acid to the transfer RNA. This step or this attachment occurs in two steps. This is the first step. The first step in which the amino acid, it is the ATP is hydrolyzed, and the one bond is broken down here. One high energy bond is, or one the energy which is equivalent to one ATP, it is released, and also PPI pyrophosphate is released, which will further broken down into the two inorganic phosphate. Two high energy bonds they have been broken down, and energy equivalent to two ATP it has been released. So enzyme E, it is attached with the amino acid, and in the next step, the AMP and enzyme. It is released, and the amino acid, it is linked with the 3 prime end of the transfer RNA. So this is the two-step reaction. It also has the proofreading activity. It requires the ATP, as we have seen in the diagram. It has the proofreading or editing activity, which can remove the incorrect amino acid from the enzyme or the transfer RNA. The next enzyme is the peptidyl transferase, which is required in the protein synthesis. It catalyzes the peptide bond formation and transfer the amino acid from the P site to the A site. mRNA is also required for the synthesis of the polypeptide chain. It must be present. Functional ribosomes, they are real factories for the synthesis of proteins. They are complexes of proteins and ribosomal RNA. Predominantly, these ribosomes, they have the ribosomal RNA, and 35% is the protein. So predominantly ribosome contain the ribosomal RNA. As you all know, its structure, that there are two subunit, larger subunit and smaller subunits. You have studied many times the structure of eukaryotic and prokaryotic ribosomes. This is the good presentation of eukaryotic and prokaryotic ribosomes, their ribosomal species, their RNA species, and the proteins which are linked with the 70S and 70S prokaryotic ribosomes and 80S eukaryotic ribosomes. There are two types of ribosome: rough endoplasmic ribosome and smooth endoplasmic ribosomes. The rough endoplasmic ribosomes synthesize that proteins which are exported from the cell, that are destined to become incorporated into the plasma, endoplasmic reticulum or Golgi bodies, or they are transported into the lysosomes. Another ribosomes, which is not rough endoplasmic reticulum, the cytosolic ribosomes, they synthesize proteins required in the cytosol itself or destined for the nucleus, mitochondria and peroxisomes. Mitochondria contain their own set of ribosomes and their own unique circular DNA. So what are the A, P and E site? What are A, P and E site? These are A, P and E site. They are the binding sites for the transfer RNA on ribosomes on 3 codons: A codon, P codon and E codon. At A site, incoming amino acyl transfer RNA, they bind. At the P site, P is for peptidyl, it is occupied by that transfer RNA which synthesize polypeptide chain between the amino acid. E site, which is occupied by the transfer RNA, which is going to exit from the ribosomal machinery, and this is empty transfer RNA. What are the factors which require for the initiation of the translation, elongation and termination of the translation? There are many protein factors which are required. Some of these factors, they have catalytic function, and some they appear to stabilize the synthetic machinery. Some have the regulatory roles. So these are the initiation factors. the three elongation factors, both for the prokaryotes and eukaryotes, and three releasing factors, single releasing factor for the eukaryotes and three releasing factor for the prokaryotes. And for the cofactors, magnesium is required. Energy calculation. Energy calculation, there are two ATPs are required. We have already seen that two ATPs, they are required for the functioning of amino acid transfer RNA synthetase. And for the GTP, one for the binding of amino acid transfer RNA to the A site and one for the translocation. Also, additional ATP and GTP molecules are required for initiation in the eukaryotes, whereas an additional GTP molecule is required for termination in both eukaryotes and prokaryotes. Codon anticodon recognition. How 50 transfer RNA molecules they can compensate the 64 codons for the 20 amino acids. There are 20 amino acids, 64 codons, and about 30 to 40 transfer RNA in bacteria and 50 in the human. This is described by a Wobel hypothesis. Wobel hypothesis says that single transfer RNA recognize more than one codon. How 3 prime base of codon, this is the third base of the codon, recognize specifically third base of the codon not recognized specifically by the fifth base of the anticodon. First two bases of the mRNA, they always form the strong Watson and Crick base pairs with the corresponding bases of transfer RNA anticodon. Only the first base of anticodon determine the number of codon recognized by the transfer RNA. See, this is the picture which shows that the first two bases, they have the correct base pairing, but the third pairing is non-traditional. This non-traditional base pairing is, I have told you before, that this is the third position of the codon and the first 5 prime position of the anticodon. See, the first bases of the in the transfer RNA, they are the AG, and the first base in the mRNA are the UG. They have the traditional pairing. So in the transfer RNA and in the mRNA, these two first bases, they have the traditional pairing. What happens in the third pairing on the transfer RNA? It can recognize U, it can recognize, it can make the bond with U, and if there is the G on the transfer RNA, it will bind, it can bind both on C and U. And if there is U on transfer RNA, it can bind with both A and G. The bond between U and A, it is traditional, but additionally it can have the non-traditional pairing between G. So UG can also form the base pairing. If there is the C, the pairing will be the traditional. If there is the hypoxanthine on the 3 prime end at the third base in the transfer RNA, the mRNA, it can bond with 3 of the nucleotides. They are the U, C and A. So third position of the codon and the first five position of the anticodon, there is the non-traditional base pairing. There are some examples of the base traditional base pairing which I have discussed. So this is the what are this is what all about what are the components required for the protein synthesis. In my next lecture I will discuss the steps which are needed in order to complete the process of translation. Till then, best wishes. Allah Hafiz.